Yes, I believe we are ready to begin. This is the Children and Families Committee. We have a very brief, short meeting today because we have two bills that we will be voting on, and one bill we will be holding for some amendments. So we won't have a discussion on that today. That will be for a later time. We have present Senator Serino, who was here briefly and could not stay. Senator Tedesco is here. Senator Prasad is here. And Senator Felder is here. We have the voting sheets from Senator Salazar and Senator Kaplan. So we will, I think we have a quorum, we can begin. And why don't we start with the first bill? Our council will read that.
The first bill is S-7547 by Senator Montgomery, an act to amend the social services law in relation to waiving the requirement of establishing paternity or a child support order for certain applicants or recipients of aid to dependent children.
And just simply, if I can just hopefully create some understanding why we're doing this. There are a lot of guardians who are kin guardians, and they often have children in their care that they need support for, but they are denied support because they are required to by the court to get enforcement of the child support from the parent. So what we're trying to do is to remove that barrier to families who are taking care of their children. Oh, we're now joined by Senator Salazar. Thank you, Senator. We're just discussing the first bill. And so it's very simply to remove the barrier to kin caregivers to receiving assistance on a child-only basis, even though they are not able to get child support from the parent of the child. So, and this is a huge problem because so many children are cared for by kin relatives. And so this will give them an opportunity to receive some support. Yes. And so this is really, and it's supported very widely, but it's one of those bills in particular. They're very, very, because they really work with kin caregivers all over the state. And so this comes from them as well. So,
okay.
Just a couple questions.
Yes.
What exactly is the barrier that we're removing?
So, typically, if a kin gap guardian wants to receive the TANF child-only grant, they have to establish paternity for the child, and sometimes the reason why the child is not with the parent is due to some, you know, reason, whether it be alcoholism or things of that nature. So this, if they show good cause for a reason why they're not establishing the paternity, they would be able to still receive the grant.
And so that would be paid for by the state?
Well, there's no fiscal implication to the state.
But they're getting child support, right?
They're getting child-only support through TANF program.
Normally, it would be through the parent.
Well, theoretically, it would be. But in these cases, in particular, it's not possible to receive anything from the parent.
Tamara has this question.
So I just want to make a clarification. So this would come from the TANF grant, which is federally funded. So it won't be a fiscal necessarily to the state, but it'd be a fiscal to the federal monies in which we receive, which are mostly subscribed. So there may be a cost that, so let's just make sure you understand that piece.
Yeah.
But in terms of them receiving the grant, say for instance, the caregiver is establishing care but needs financial assistance. So they go to the local social services district to apply for this child-only grant. They're asked to assent to the state collecting child support. There may be some issue of domestic violence or some other family issue, and the caregiver doesn't want to cause a family disruption by seeking child support from the parent who no longer has custody or guardianship of the child. So if they establish good cause, the state will say, no, we're not going to seek the child support. And there's federal guidance that encourages states to do such. And so there's something to codify the federal guidance into state law.
Is there an assembly sponsor to this?
Not as of yet.
Okay.
I'm going to go back to the
assembly
sponsor.
I can't do both jobs at once. Come on. I spent 34 years over there. I like it here with you.
Oh, wonderful. We're glad to have you, sir. Any more questions?
I'm all set.
You're all set. Okay.
Move the bill.
Second.
Second.
Thank you, Senator Sullivan.
I'm going to be aye without rec on that.
Okay. Any no votes? Thank you. The bill is reported. And next bill, I think it's Senator Kennedy's bill.
Yes, S-773, Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the social services law in relation to implementing the cost estimation model for child care.
Any discussion, questions?
So there will be some cost to this bill?
Correct.
It goes to finance. It's referred to finance. When we vote for it. It doesn't go directly.
Any assembly sponsor on this?
I'm not sure.
Currently, Assembly has not introduced a same as version this year.
All right. Any no votes? Any?
I'd be aye without rec.
Without rec. And the bill is reported to finance. And thank you, members. That's it. Any other discussion?
Everybody has a copy of your budget letter.
I was just going to say, this is FYI. It's in-house only. It's not anything official. But I just wanted to share with members what we're suggesting in our memo. I think you have more information than you need or care to see. But at least, especially as it relates to our committee request.
Okay. And I think all of you signed on to the youth bill letter that's in there as well.
The youth bill letter you have. So, and thank you for that. I appreciate the support for youth bill. And could I just say, officially, while we are still on camera, although we're not necessarily supposed to do this, but I have a group of young people from my district, and I really am so proud to be able to acknowledge them. They are with an organization. You will see that organization on my list. It's the Opportunities for Better Tomorrow. And I think that Senator Salazar knows this as well. So we welcome you, and we really appreciate the
In
work
my former
that
life,
do.
I hired staff from OBT.
I did.
So now you see what we do. And let me just say, we have a Republican in the room. Senator Tedisco is a very famous Republican from the Hall.
Is that like an elephant in the room?
He's the elephant in the room. So, but we welcome you so that you now see sort of a little bit of how the sausage gets made. The bills that we vote on in our committee go eventually. Last you see one of them, it will go to another committee, which is the Finance Committee. Sometimes bills go to two committees from us, but also eventually we hope that they'll get to the floor and be voted on. And Senator Disco very often votes no, but we vote yes, and vice versa. That's how it works here. This is the process that you're witnessing right here. So thank you guys for coming.
Thank you so much.